Hi Leo, this is your weekly oracle and tarot card reading from Born Without Boundaries. For those of you who are just discovering me, this is Born Without Boundaries. My name is Michelle. Welcome to the channel. Thank you so much for being curious and enjoy the reading. This is an oracle card reading, and then down below there's a link to an extended video to lead you over to Vimeo where there will be a full tarot card spread as well as a romance reading, both in the same video. Now, for those of you who are on platforms that allow for commercials, expect there to be a commercial break coming up in a couple of seconds. Let me explain. That is your contribution to the channel. Without any money or any donation at all, it's just being patient and sitting through a commercial actually helps the channel so much. And I thank you for that. So there's going to be a commercial coming up in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I'll see you in a couple of seconds. For those of you who just sat through an awkward pause, thank you for dealing with that. For those of you who actually sat through a commercial, thank you for your contribution. It's greatly appreciated. Let's get into the reading. Okay. All right, Leo. This is your oracle card reading on this side for the week of October 8th through the 16th of 2019. We're picking up on general energies. I promise you I'll try, Leo, to be... Two cards already popped out. Damn, somebody's speaking to you. Oh my, Leo. Let's see what's going on. Upside down and reversed. Know your worth. Leo, this is a stinker is in your midst. This is a stinker is in your midst and trying to diminish you. The miracles are endless. This, I'm telling you right now, this is a message of an intentional block. An intentional block. This is a nasty motherfucker who has intentionally harmed you, who has intentionally put a stop or a block on your progress and your abundance. It's also spirit saying there's a shit ton of abundance here. There's a shit ton of abundance waiting for Leo, but it can't get through because somebody is stinking it up and they're doing it intentionally. Now, normally, Leo, this is, you know, sort of you trying to like dress yourself up and like trying to pretend you're something that you're not. This is somebody that is false, that is fake, trying to pretend that, like doing something shady, doing something underhanded to block your blessings. The other interpretation for these two cards together is you deciding to stop pretending and stop worrying about what other people think about you, because when you were, it was blocking your blessings. Now, for a Leo, that is not your even mentality. Not to say that you guys can't get insecure, but to say that, no, there's definitely somebody stinking up the weeds. There's definitely something going on that is rotten. Like something's rotten in the state of Denmark. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like Hamlet's uncle was the traitor and he couldn't prove it at first. If you ever see the play Hamlet, you read it. We all read it in high school if we're in the United States, right? Because it's required curriculum. It's part of the core curriculum. You know what I'm saying? But it's true. And it was a great, it's a great play. Hamlet knew from the very beginning that something was up. There was a feeling, there was a sense, and it wasn't just Hamlet. It was sort of the atmosphere itself. It was foggy, it was dense, it was dark. There was an air of sickness. There was an air of something isn't right, because something wasn't right. Something was bad. Somebody had actually, the brother of the king, Hamlet's father, had killed him. Spoiler alert, I'm sorry. I'm just assuming, you know, it's like a 6-7 year, no. It's a 600-year-old play. I'm assuming people have already read it, but I don't know. All right. Spoiler alert. This is how Hamlet goes. So Hamlet literally is like, he's moody as fuck. Oh God, I want to smack him half the time. Even if somebody brilliant plays him, he's really very confused kind of character. He has a hard time making decisions and like, you know, growing his balls and putting his big boy pants on and finally like doing some shit about stuff. You know what I'm saying? But he can feel that something's wrong. And it's almost his vacillation is his own denial of wanting to actually see what's actually happening. And the truth eventually comes out that it was his father's brother, his uncle, that killed him just so that he could get the crown. But even worse for Hamlet, what made Hamlet even more sick was that his mother, you know, his father was barely cold in the ground when his mother turned around and started fucking his uncle. And it made him see her as a totally different person. You know what I'm saying? So there was an almost like incestuous kind of really like that's what I'm saying, like deep, dark underworld betrayal. So this could actually be the betrayal of somebody that you think is your friend, that you think is helping you, but they're actually stinking up your flower garden. And they don't intend to move. They're doing it intentionally, but they're disguising themselves as one of the flowers itself. Remember Flower, that cute little character from Bambi, how he was a skunk? Well, this is if he were a motherfucker, okay? And he was trying to disguise his tomfoolery, his bad intentions, his malignancy, if you will, as a flower, as something good, like dressing it up as something beautiful, as, oh, we're actually here to help. So Leo, if you have been feeling vibes that somebody is intentionally messing with you, this is your confirmation. Somebody is intentionally messing with you, Leo, and it's almost gotten you to the point where you're like punching walls. You don't really know what to do about it. Because as much as you guys are like, you could say it's, you're arrogant, you're this, you're that, you're not fucking shady. It's like you're the sun. Sun isn't shady. You know, you may love people's attention and be, you know, like love yourself, but you naturally, I know there's some bad, nasty Leos out there. I'm going to get the comments. Well, my Leo is a narcissist fucker who betrayed me. Okay. And you're a cross watcher watching somebody else's video. So put it away for a second because this is what Leo is going through. Try to be empathetic toward their situation this week. That's all I'm asking. So, Leo, normally you guys are too confident to think about backstabbing because things kind of come easy for you. They kind of like people are attracted to you. You know what I'm saying? They give you jobs. They want you around. It's like the door is open for Leo. You kind of have that blessing about you, right? You're fortunate that way. So you don't usually need to go and do shady shit. So I don't think it would occur to you that somebody was intentionally being shady to you. But after a while, you just start smelling the stink. For however much perfume is going on, for however much cover-up is going on, the stink starts like a dead corpse, all right? A zombie in your fields is gonna start to smell because the rot is the rot and you can't get around it. And I feel like this week, Leo, here's your sign, here's your warning. The rot is the rot. Don't get around it. Go out there, chop off zombie heads, and put a bullet through that brain because you got to kill the brain stem cell. Like there's definitely, something is definitely rotten in the state of Leo. So Leo, this is your confirmation. Go out there and track it down because something is going wrong. And you know it. It's not just your life feels like, because I get those readings too. I would tell you if that's what was happening. If this is a perception, like the world is against me this week, it's not a perception. This is actually something not being correct. That's what's going on. Like I can't say it any other way. I can't articulate it any other way. I'm clearly going to continue to pull more cards and I will also turn it around. I'll put my camera on the camera stand, which is over to the side, and I'll let you see the spread and I'll go through it again with you. But this is definitely a confirmation that something is awry. I will do a full tarot spread over on Vimeo where we can get more in detail about what the fuck is going on. And maybe I can pinpoint where this is coming from. Yeah. Ooh, it's so weird too. I was shuffling those cards, Leo. And they were just like sitting on the table. I didn't even realize they popped out. Something is rotten in the state of Denmark, Leo. Something is rotten in the state of Denmark. You know, when you shine like the sun, it's easy to take aim at you. I'm sure that you're not new to this either. I'm sure. Either that or, yes, the energies could be reversed and it could be some nasty Leo who's being the one to make other people look bad, to make themselves look better, because they're an attention hog and they are narcissistic and they absolutely do need the attention. So they're getting it in bad ways. They're getting it in underhanded ways just so they could be on top and get something that they don't deserve. That is a possibility as well. But I'm saying it's like 95 to 5%. There's like that 5% that are real Mac nasties. And Leo, I hope this isn't you, but there's maybe 5% of you out there that's like this. But most of you, it's reading about, the reading is telling you, like confirming, there has literally been this sort of guerrilla warfare action against you. Now, where to begin? I don't know. But one thing that came around, and once again, it's also backwards, this is taking the wind out of you, Leo. It is. It's taking the piss out of you. It's knocking the wind out of you. That's what's going on. Because you honestly have been trying your hardest and you don't understand what's happening. You really, and there would be no way for you to understand. The reason why you don't understand what's happening is because you don't have that backward, DL, spiteful, vengeful, evil kind of brain. You don't have it. So you wouldn't think it. You think, well, I'm gonna work even harder. I'm gonna do even more. I'm gonna shine even brighter. But you can't counter this. This is like somebody throwing iron in your sun, right? Like intentionally trying to kill you, like poisoning your food supply. Like you don't know. I'm not saying that's literally what's happening. I hope that's literally not what's happening. But this is somebody that is intentionally wearing you down. And this is my, you know, diva card, right? This is even bigger than the lion. This is just like, this is not bigger than the lion, but this is like feeling real good about yourself, looking classy, being sassy, eccentric, standing out. This is you being diminished and feeling drained because of this happening to you. You don't get what's going on. It doesn't, because it doesn't make any sense. You would have to think like a criminal to understand what's going on with you this week. That's what you would have to think like. Trust in the magic. I want to keep turning these cards over. This and that are true. Okay, so there is an experience that you can learn from this. The only reason why spirit is letting this happen is because it is an educational process for you. That's all. And it could be an educational process in just gearing up for better defense against yourself, like teaching you what's out there. Because if you level up even further, then if it's bad now, think how bad it could get. It wants you to have this experience when you're still safe and blanketed, kind of. Because if you explode, then guess what? Guess what kind of energy? And then you would definitely have to be able to know how to protect yourself. This is almost like your training round, is what I think this is. Sing your own song. So A, keep doing you, keep being yourself. Leo, keep being consistent. Keep sharing your word, keep sharing your voice, keep sharing your truth. Do not outwardly let this affect what you create, the job that you do, the work that you do, the message that you give. Don't let it infect you and what you believe in. Here is a renewal of your song. Here's a reminder from spirit. What you have is valuable. What you have is quite beautiful. Keep singing the song. Keep singing that tune. It will break through. Just give me a second. Spirit has your back. Spirit has your back, Leo. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. 10 to 1, and this is 23 too. So this is your lucky number. This is my lucky number. So I know this is a really good card. This also means something like, I mean, it could be all the way like up to government espionage and shit. And it's trickled down to you. Like that could be how big this is. But something has to do with eyes that are bigger than yours know this is happening. I remember my sister is in Leo. She's a Sagittarius, but she had her social security number stolen. We don't know how, she doesn't know how it was stolen, but there were tens of thousands of dollars ranked up in debt on credit cards. There were even traffic tickets because somebody had used her social security number to get a license under her name. And they had speeding tickets racked up. So much shit. And she was in the middle of a nightmare. I have to tell you, 4 years she was in the middle of a nightmare. It still cost. She didn't have to pay the tens of thousands of dollars of credit card debt that they racked up. But she had to pay over 4 years' time, $10,000 worth of fees for a lawyer to help her through the process because somebody was victimizing her. And she didn't do anything. And there was just somebody fucking nasty who was out to get something for themselves. And they didn't care who they hurt in the process. And Leo, that's what I'm feeling that you're dealing with, but you've been dealing with them. And I feel like this sort of compromised sense of self has probably been going on for a couple of months, but this week it culminates into an exposure, into you realizing that you're not insane and you getting a message or you getting intel that let you know something is really, we know something's going wrong. We know something's up. Something isn't right. It's not just your intuition or your arrogance that says, "Oh, I can't fail. Something must be going wrong if I fail." That's not what's happening. What's happening is something's actually going wrong. And this is higher eyes are on it. They know it. In other words, when my sister went through what she went through with having her identity stolen, finally, the Social Security Department itself, like that's what I'm saying, like government, it's this high, went through, contacted her through an official notice. They don't call you. You don't get calls from the IRS or the Social Security Department. They have to put everything in writing and it has to be official through the USPS. It has to be stamped. So if you're getting a call, it's a complete scam. But this was an official letter from the Social Security Department letting her know that they'd recognized, without her even contacting them, that something had happened to her Social Security number and it had been compromised. And it was with that letter that she was able to go to a lawyer, hire a lawyer, and defend herself in court and get her credit report and her driver's license completely cleared. So it was, this is what I'm saying. You may not be dealing with like government espionage, something that high, but it is like the company that you're working for. Some like higher eyes have seen what's going on. And I guarantee you, Leo, it's happening to more than just you. It's not just you. You are being singled out because you stand out, but there are other people being singled out too, probably because they stand out too. Somebody wants to mute the sun so that their little shadowy ass can shine or feel like they do. And you know, it's those nasty creatures on earth that are just desperate and pathetic that have to dim somebody else's shine in order to feel even half good about themselves. And that's the kind of nastiness you're dealing with. It could also, you know, it could be bigger than just a person. It probably is. It's probably just like, we want to make money. We want to make money, so we're going to cut down the little guy or the person that's rising just to make sure that everybody invests or looks at these people over here. I'm telling you right now, this is big shit. And let me turn the cards around. This is a good time to do it. Hold on. Okay, Leo. So here's your card view. You see that this is the crowning energy. The crowning energy of your blessings being blocked by somebody who is definitely deceptive. They are a stinker in your garden. They are intentionally trying to cover themselves up. They are doing this in some sort of coverted, subverted fashion, but is absolutely malefic and malignant. It's intentional and it's disease spreading. This is you with a compromised sense of self. Normally you'd be all up diva and shit. And the bell's ringing. Normally you'd be all up diva, right? Normally you'd be all kinds of up diva and be really stable because it's a four card. But this has actually turned you on your head and made you question, like, what's wrong with me? Why am I not getting ahead? Why is there no movement for me? Because you're not cheating. That's who this person is. They're a cheater. They're cheating. They're cheating for their own gain so that their own gain is easier. This isn't somebody who goes to the gym and works hard 10 hours a day
and studies and trains and devotes themselves and eats a strict diet and has a strict schedule and does it for years and then shows up at the UFC and wins a title. That's not who this person is. This is somebody who wants to like work out a couple of hours, build up their name, get the market on their side, and meanwhile, they're like covertly drugging people's motherfucking, like, I don't know, protein shakes to like give them stomach viruses so that on the day of the fight, they're weakened so that whoever they're backing or supporting or whoever they are can win. You see what I'm saying? This is a cheater. This isn't somebody that's just playing the game better. This is somebody who's cheating the system. And that's why your blessings have been blocked, because Leo, you're not a cheater of the system. You're usually like the poster child for the system. Like, you usually don't have to cheat the system. That's why you wouldn't think of doing it, because the system usually works for you. The system's all about the Kang. You know what I'm saying? So it wouldn't occur to you, most of you, yes, this could be in reverse, where you have a nasty Leo in your presence who is, in other words, this would be a Leo who is so low vibrational, they're so arrogant and egotistical because they have no self-esteem whatsoever. And because they're a Leo, they just need more attention than they deserve. And whether or not they deserve it, they're going to get it, and they're going to get it at all costs. That would, if it's a Leo. And like I said, it's maybe 95.5%. That's not what's mostly happening. Mostly what's happening is the Leos are the ones that have been compromised. That's why it's their reading. But you could be in the presence of a Leo who is just so fucking desperate for attention, they would have done anything in order to get what they want. But then I have to say to you, that is more systemic than it is personal. Because this is more the system itself harming the individual, not an individual harming another individual. If you understand what that means. And I think that you will understand what it means, Leo, because I feel like this has been an issue for quite some time. And at first you didn't even react. You know what you did as a Leo? You're just like, well, I'm going to get stronger. I'm going to fight harder. I'm going to double down. People love me. Because you have confidence, and it wouldn't occur to you that people don't love you or people are working against you. Right? And then suddenly it gets really, really clear. It gets very, very clear to you. Oh no, no matter how hard I work. In fact, the harder I work, the harder it gets. And then I let go, and I try to like let go and let God. And that's not working either. And that's when you realize there's something. There's a consciousness behind the malignancy. There is a consciousness behind the malignancy. So this is in somebody or some system intentionally doing harm. So what do you do, Leo? Know this. Number one, this is your sign. This week, now you can start to look for reasons and start to build your case. And in the process, keep doing you. While you're in this mucky in-between place, continue to sing your song. Your song itself will bring the dolphin around, right? And bring it out of the muck, out of the in-between. That you keep singing your song and keep being true to who you are, because honestly, there's a whole other sort of system of light that has recognized and has its eyes on what's happening here. Because it's not just happening to you. I'm telling you, it's systemic. I'm telling you, it's systemic. Trust in the magic. Trust that spirit has your back. Trust it. Because this has been growing. Do you see? This is no coincidence. This is the hatchling, and this is the full version. Yes, this is a raven and this is an eagle. But as I'm saying, it's a hatchling, and then this is the full version. This is the adult version. This has been maturing for quite some time. This has been growing for quite some time. And the reason why you are put in this situation is to really hone in your skills, learn your song, tune up, because you're about to blow up. You're about to take the lead. You're about to be seen, and your abundance is about to break through. And I think this is what this is. You want to hear what I'm going to say? Whistleblower. This is whistleblower. This is somebody exposing. Look it. You see this birdie? You see the baby birdie? Right there? Leo, right there? You see? He's looking right up and he's blowing it. He's blowing that whistle. He's blowing the whistle on all this shit. So either you're going to be the beneficiary of a whistleblower, of somebody uncovering that all of this is going on, or you're going to be the whistleblower yourself. But here's your sign, baby. Here's your sign. Let's go over to Vimeo. If you want specifics, the Vimeo link is below. I'm going to go deep. I really want to know what the fuck this is. I want to know what's going on. Because I have three of my signs in Leo. I tell you, it's about self-defense for me. I got my Mercury. I got my Venus. And I think it's my Saturn or Uranus. I got to check my chart. But somebody's definitely messing with me. Somebody's definitely messing with us. And it's about high time we figured it out. So Leo, I'll see you over on Vimeo.